Hello, I'm Simon Pedley, and I'm here today to talk to you about the new concrete scanner from RDS, the see-through. Now, this concrete scanner is GPR, so what it allows us to do is image anything that's in the ground. GPR works very simply off material density changes, so as we push this system across the ground, we're going to get that image of exactly what is in a concrete slab or a concrete wall. Now, we class this system as an all-in-one scanner because everything's built into the one piece of hardware. On top, we have our large LCD screen, touchscreen, and daylight readable. We have encoders on all four wheels, and we also have laser distance meters on all three sides. This is what allows us to position this system very accurately when we're doing our 3D data collection, which we'll touch on shortly. In addition to that, we also have two antennas in the system. These are at two different polarizations, and the joy of this polarization is it allows us to get down to 38 inches within a slab of concrete. So what do I mean by a dual antenna system, or dual polarized? Well, the see-through has two antennas, but importantly, at different orientations or positions, and this is what allows us to see that 38 inches within a concrete slab. So what we have is we have an antenna at the front. This is mounted horizontally, and I've called this HH in the graphic that I've shown on the screen here. As you can see, we can see that first level of rebar very well. Now, in addition to the first level of rebar, we want to be able to see deeper in a slab. We want to be able to see the post tension. We want to be able to see the conduits, the power lines. We want to see those additional things. We want to see that extra depth. So what we also have at the back of the system is a vertically mounted antenna, and on the graphic I've called this out as VV. As you can see, we get a clear picture of everything that's within that slab. Now let's collect some data. We can do it in two ways, but the first way we're going to cover is the 3D visualization. This is where we lay a track put onto the ground and run the see-through over a grid system so we can clearly see what's within this concrete slab. Before we start working with the see-through, let's see what the kit comes with. So obviously we get the see-through. I currently have a battery inserted in there at the moment, and everything else is within this Pelican case. So it's going to keep everything well organized and very well protected. So in addition to the battery that's already in, I have two additional batteries in here as well. So we've got all day working with this system. And obviously, as you'd expect, the relevant chargers. Now, the most important thing when we're doing our grid scan is obviously the grid setup. So these are 16 inches long and we supply six of them. So the biggest work area you have is 4 feet by 4 feet. Now, when we lay these out, we're going to make sure this reflective strip is facing inwards towards the scanner. So on the scanner, remember, we have these laser distance meters that we can see on all three sides. So what is required for those to position itself very accurately is those reflective strips, and that's what gives us full control over where we're doing our scans. So in addition, we also have these guides. This is what we use in conjunction with these track pads to ensure that everything is kept as rigid and as square as possible. Now let me lay this grid out, and then we can start doing our scan. So I've laid my grid out. I'm only going to use a small grid because I've only got a small area of interest. So I've used 2x2 slats, so it's 32 inches by 32 inches, as each one is 16 inches in length. So I'm going to do a grid scan, as I said, to give us that 3D visualization of what is actually in this slab. So to get going, very simple. I've just got one button to hit. I hit the 3D visualization button on the top right, and the system will start and calibrate itself for this ground condition right here. And then once I have that, I can then see a ghosted see-through, should we say, on the screen. So anywhere I move this, the see-through follows me, just like the mouse does on your computer. So I can do my scans. Very simple, very easy. I just drag the see-through to one of the start points, one of the collection points, and these are denoted by these marks down here. So we can either do a dense scan every 2 inches or open that up to every 4 inches, okay? When I'm in the correct location, one of the lines will light bright pink. When it's pink, I can hit the play button bring the unit back and collect that data, getting full information while I'm doing the scan as well as trying to produce this 3D visualization. So now I've collected the data, let's look at what is in this concrete slab. So I can go back and review any of the scan lines. The scan lines are shown on the screen as grey lines. If I want to move to any of them to see that radargram, I simply move the see-through over till I get a pink line underneath a grey one, and that's going to show the radargram of that particular line. But I want to see that visualization of what's in this concrete slab. So I'm going to turn off that radargram. And now I can just see the see-through alone and the scan lines. I'm going to merge that data together to give us a visualization that we've been looking for. And that was when we can see this multi-layered view. I'm looking at this whole slab in one hit, not needing to go through at different levels. So if I want to mark a place to drill, let's say safely, I can simply drag the see-through to a point where there are no rebars or anything showing on the screen. If I want to mark it, I'd mark the front of the see-through. If I want to mark a rebar, again, I'd move it forward till I see one of those grey lines, and again, I could mark it. We're being totally tracked by the track pad system built into the unit. So the final way we can use a see-through is by using it in quick scan mode. This is the fastest way to get information directly from the see-through and see what is in that slab, but we do need to use the radargram to achieve this. To use the see-through in the quick scan mode is very simple. We hit the top left button. Our radar window will open. We simply press the play button at our start point. Run the system up the wall. And we're looking for a hyperbola or an anomaly that we want to investigate. I can see a hyperbola on the screen. I'm going to roll it back until the red line is in the center of that hyperbola. And if I want to mark the wall, I would mark the front of the see-through as the location.